Lying down beside you, what's going through your head? The silence in the air felt like my soul froze. Am I just overthinking feelings I can't? This gut feeling I'm trying to get off me eyes. We could all sweep it under the carpet. I hope that I can turn back the time to make it all alright. All alright for us. I promise to build a new world for us two with you.
Okay, so the pre-workout meal was 65 grams of oats, 100 grams of banana, and 55 grams of whey protein. Chocolate flavor and 145 grams of lean ground beef.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to the YouTube channel.
Yeah, yo, guys, welcome back to another video on the YouTube channel.
So I'm currently in San Diego with Haynes, but he's currently just sorting out the car. And we just drove 5 hours down from Santa Barbara yesterday because it's Halloween weekend. And on Halloween weekend in Isla Vista, where we stay on the campus, it gets too hectic on Halloween, so most people just go home or go somewhere else for the weekend. So we decided to come to Haynes' place in SD. So we're currently at Crunch Fitness, about to hit chest and tries. And yeah, I'm really excited, very grateful to be here. Something I love about these American gyms is that if you just come in, you can always pretty much get a 3 week trial. And in England, like, you need to get day passes and things like that. But here, like, the customer service, you can almost always get a free week trial. So it's so nice traveling, because you know you're going to be able to get your workout in.
How's it feel?
First exercise, we just did incline Smith. That's pretty standard, like anywhere you go, they're gonna have an incline Smith. But this session is the exact one that I actually filmed in depth in the last video. So if you wanna see this workout from start to finish in depth, that's in the last video. But on the machine exercises, this is just a tip for when traveling. They're probably not gonna have the exact same equipment. So we just had a machine flat press in our normal split, and we're just gonna switch this out for another machine flat press, even though it's slightly different. So you just wanna find a machine that is hitting basically the same muscle group from a similar angle, but it's not the exact same machine, because it's probably not going to be.
Okay,
so on this exercise right here, the machine is not ideal because the seat doesn't go low enough to get me my arms in the right position. So I'm kind of like putting more stress on my shoulders than I want to. But again, beggars can't be choosers. Like when you go to a new gym, it's probably not gonna have all the things that you want, but that's actually okay because at least it's got a similar exercise. So we're just gonna make it work. Do a couple extra warm ups just to make sure that we're locked into the movement and we're not gonna injure ourselves. Yo, Haynes, what are we doing later today? We're gonna hop in the water.
Probably get some food, go to the beach, sunbathe a bit, go on the water, go in the ocean.
Catch a couple waves.
Maybe surf.
Yeah. Aight. Excited.
Get some food.
Get some schmunch.
Oh no, he's like, oh yeah, I'm complimenting you. Like,
oh no,
no.
You should have
peace. Okay, so cut update. So I'm currently 176 pounds in the morning with 2 weeks now left of my cut. So the 3 months have been kind of flown by. I've dropped 20-ish pounds, which is a lot. And it's actually at the point now where like I'm literally hungry all the time. So at the start, it was so easy when you go from a bulk transition to a cut, you're literally chilling. Less food, you're happy. But now cardio 6 times a week, training's difficult, getting weaker, food is low. It's like, I can't really bulk right now, but I'm just trying to remember like, when I was bulking, I really wanted to be here now. And now that I'm here, I'm almost in the headspace, but like I want to be bulking again. Yeah. But you can't just always live in the future. You gotta like appreciate it now. And I'm happy now. Okay, so we're finishing the session off. And triceps with a cross-body cable tricep extension. So this is better than a rope because it just allows you to get a little bit more range of motion, but it's not the end of the world if you don't do it, but it just helps a little bit. Okay, so I'm back from the gym now. I thought I'd share real quick how I am managing eating and my diet and staying on track while I'm traveling. So first of all here, we have post-workout meal, 240 grams of jasmine rice and 145 grams of chicken. And if you can see here, if I just have everything here, we've got beef and chicken prepped. So obviously I had to take about 20 to 30 minutes just to like cook it in a big skillet. And then now I have it in Tupperware for the rest of the weekend. And so, the biggest thing here is just basically, again, cooking things in bulk. It's so important that you cook things in bulk because if I was to do all of these meals individually, it would take forever. So even when I'm back at college, I make sure that I cook everything in bulk because I don't want to be spending time and energy wasted just cooking every single meal. And then another tip is for carbs, these are gonna be a lifesaver. So Ben's original jasmine rice, where you just put in a microwave, or another really clean but easy carb to eat, the easiest one probably, is these puffed rice. So simplicity and organization, this helps me so much. And obviously, another really good thing for me right now is I'm cutting, so my food actually, volume-wise, isn't too much, which is great, because if you're bulking, traveling can be a pain because it takes so much time to then cook the volume. But actually, if you don't have too much, you can just cook it all in one go, 30 minutes of your day just to prep it, and then all you have to do is put in a microwave. Easy, job done. Okay, so it's currently the next day and we are heading back to Santa Barbara today. So it's a Sunday. I needed a quick coffee to get me caffeinated because it's a busy day today. 5-hour drive, and hopefully we can get that surf in before we head back, because the waves in San Diego are so much better than in Santa Barbara. I'm currently working on a project, which is, or an assignment for college, which is due at 11:55 tonight, and I hadn't started until today, so I'm gonna have to mash that on the car. Right now, like, I'm actually feeling tired, which is very strange because, like, my to-do list was so much shorter this weekend than obviously in college, but, like, paradoxically, like, when you have less to do, like, and you let your body relax, then you actually are more tired, as opposed to you think when you relax you'd, like, get your energy back. But I don't know, I guess your mind just, like, adjusts to, like, how much you need to do. But yeah, I'm excited for the surf today. Okay, so me being me, a question that I was thinking about the other day is, when I'm surfing, how does that relate to cardio when I'm on a cut? All right, so say I had 30 minutes of cardio to do a day, how does that get affected if I do surfing? Because surfing is obviously burning calories. And this would be my approach, because the people that kind of overthink it like me. So unless you're doing a bodybuilding show, I would say, just do your standard cardio, whether that be 30 minutes, 40 minutes, like X amount, whatever that is for you, and then do the surfing on top, and just don't worry about it. Don't try and, like, surf for a certain amount of time or be active, like, and try and keep your heart rate high while you're surfing, and, like, keep paddling even when there's no waves coming, when you're further out there, just to, like, keep burning calories. I'd say just do the 30 minutes or whatever amount you have, and then just surf on top of that. Don't stress about it. On the other hand, if you're trying to win a competition and you're trying to do the best possible prep you can, then maybe surfing is a sacrifice that you need to make. You just can't do it because it will mess up the calorie balance. And if you want to be extreme and get tick every single box, then maybe you can't do it. But for me right now, this is more, I'm not prepping for a show, but obviously I do still want to push my limits and cut as best as I can, but I'm gonna surf when I have an amazing opportunity like this. I'm not gonna miss it because of the calories that I'm gonna burn. Like, a few extra calories versus surfing in this amazing opportunity, I'm surfing. So the waves are actually all the way far out, and the camera can't zoom in that far, but we'll just try and get a white water wave so we get at least one wave on camera. Just caught a little baby wave, fell off, but in fashion though. And overall, that was super fun. That was quite cool. Kate behind the camera.
Oh yeah.
We'll see how it turned out.
What's up, guys? We're out here in. Oh, I'm Ty.
I love you, Gon. Gon is the most happy I've ever seen Gon.
I know. The vibes are right.
Okay, so post surf, we are at Rubio's, and the boys and girls are getting some munch, but the boys on that diet, so it's gonna have to be a no for me. But I really appreciate you guys making it to the end of the video. If you enjoyed the travel vlog, don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe, because I really want to grow this channel. So help your boy out. And that being said, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.